I don't know if you know, but I'm a one-man band right now.
Yeah, yeah, he told me last week at the city council that that was last night.
Well, it's not the last week trying to get her to do that.
Good, yeah.
All rise. Court of Oberlin County is now in session. The Oberlin clerk will be present.
Brother, County Secretary, Chief of Office, say.
Heavenly Father, Lord, just want to thank you for another opportunity to come and serve you and the people of this county. Lord, we want to thank you for each and everything that you've done for us along the way. We're asking you to be with us today as we make decisions that affect the lives of many people. Lord, that you just lead, guide, and direct us on where we should go. We ask you this in your heavenly sweet name. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Victoria, call the roll, please.
Donna Savage.
Here.
Robbie Melton.
Here.
Darwin Clark.
Here.
Patrick McCurdy. Lee Richards.
Here.
Randall Boswell.
Here.
Gil McCowan. Jesse Bowman.
Here.
Roger Carr.
Here.
Jeremy Walker.
Here.
Philip Tally.
Here.
Greg Nimmons.
Here.
Shane Walker.
Here.
Cindy Robbins.
Here.
We have 12 present. We have a quorum. Number five, approve the minutes for February 13, 2023, the County Commission meeting. And motion, second motion by Donna Savage. Second by Robbie Melton. Everybody signify by saying yes.
Yes.
All four. Okay. Likewise saying no. Motion carried. Number six, consider approval for resolution 2023-0313-01, authorizing Oberlin County Ambulance Director to increase the ambulance service rates, approved by the Budget Committee and Public Safety Committee. Jim, you want to give them a quick down and dirty on it? What?
Answer any questions that they have.
Basically, we'll have to increase the Medicaid rate because they change. And so he just gets in compliance with those rates, what he's trying to do. So, motion by Jesse, second by Jeff Walton. Clerk, call the roll.
Cindy Robbins.
Yes.
Shane Walker.
Yes.
Greg Nimmons.
Yes.
Philip Tally.
Yes.
Geraldine Walker.
Yes.
Roger Carr.
Yes.
Jesse Bowman.
Yes.
Randall Boswell.
Yes.
Lee Richards.
Yes.
Darwin Clark.
Yes.
Robbie Melton.
Yes.
Jeff Long.
Yes.
Donna Savage.
Yes.
Carried. Number seven, consider approval of resolution 2023-0313-02 to request the General Assembly Board to approve the Oberlin County, Tennessee Private Act for adoption jurisdiction. This is required by a two-thirds majority vote. Of course, we don't have a full quorum, so we'll have 8 votes to do the two-thirds majority. But what it is that Darrell is asking the legislators do a private act so we can start adopting here in Oberlin County. It's no cost to Oberlin County for anything. It's going to be a blessing for all of us in this area. So, got a motion by Donna Savage, got a second by
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Phil Tally?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
All four, motion carries, so we'll get the generals. I guess we'll have to get Representative Butler to sit that down for us, is that who we do?
He said he would, Darryl said he'd talk to him.
Alright, so we'll probably hear more about that in a couple days. Number eight, consider approval of the county paying $5,000 for a grant writer for the drug recovery court, approved by the budget committee. Now, this is the same, they're asking the same amount of money for the state grant writer that did six years ago for Darryl Drucker. It's been a wonderful thing to have, it's not talked about at the time, and they can help a lot of people, so. I need a motion to approve the $5,000, motion by Cindy, second by Geraldine Walker, clerk, call the row.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Phil Tally?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Donna Savage?
Yes.
All four, motion carries. Number nine, consider approval of quarterly school board reports through December 31, approved by the budget and education committee. Has everybody had a chance to look over the quarterly school reports? Does anybody have a question? Got a motion by Randall, got a second by Donna Savage, any discussion? Clerk, call the row, please.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Phil Tally?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Donna Savage?
Yes.
Alright, motion carries. Number 10, consider approval of the following budget amendments, federal budget from 142, amendment number 4, 5, 56, general purpose fund 141, amendment number 2, and number 3, and central cafeteria fund 143, amendment number 2. This has been approved by the budget committee and education committee. Got a motion by Phil Tally, second by Roger Carr, call the row, please.
Donna Savage?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Phil Tally?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
Motion carries, all four. Number 11, consider approval of the annual highway roads and cemetery list approved by the budget committee, highway and county property committee. Of course, you have to, all y'all know, we have to have the county road list and cemetery list approved each year by the committee. Motion by Jesse, and second by Jeff Long, we call the row, please.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Phil Tally?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Donna Savage?
Yes.
All four, motion carries. Number 12, consider approval for adding Quail Ridge Lane to the county road list and maps approved by the planning and highway and county property committee. Basically, Quail Ridge is off Swan Lane down in the lower end of the county. It's been through all its proper steps, so if y'all are gonna take a motion to approve that, the actual list. Got a motion by Donna Savage, second by Shane Walker, we call the row, please.
Donna Savage?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Phil Tally?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
All four, motion carries. Number 13, consider approval to remove the end section of 160 feet of Bertram Murphy Lane from county road list and maps. John Nesbitt is here, that's Representative Davis. Anything you wanna say before the court, John?
I'd like to answer, unless you've got some questions, I don't wanna take up your time.
That property down there is
bought all that property down there at the end of the
Yes.
road, so this is the last of it up there going all the way up to the gate.
Yes.
Think they've been going down there for 100 years, you know. I know that don't make it right.
It don't matter, no, we can't, it just does, love it.
Well, the big thing is.
I know that don't make it right, but they, you know, since we give a little bit, they got a little bit more, and they got a little bit more, now they got lost.
Well, hopefully we're gonna straighten it out.
Well, let's hope so, because that's the end of it, right there.
Well, we're gonna fix that turnaround at the end of, we'll cover the end of the county road to make those turnarounds, two lines, go down that little two lane, and then back up. Big thing is, if you're paying property taxes, and need to pass the toll over to the property.
I've got nothing against the people down there or anything, it's just, the other people, you know, we had 100 calls, but I'm not in that district anymore. Hundreds of calls on that down there, we used to patrol it all the time.
Hopefully we keep Sheriff Coon out and down, that's what our goal is.
Sheriff Coon?
Sorry.
Wrong sheriff, wrong county.
He's up there, isn't he? Keep the sheriff down there, he's having to go down there.
We'll keep Brandon out.
Yeah, Brandon, exactly, keep him out of court.
You just say like it's getting be a ongoing trend, people moving in, kept closing county roads, just over and over and over, just getting it out of hand, I think.
Well, you know, it's, I guess, price of progress, people moving in, you know, we're gonna have to do a better job about having, you know, open and closed roads. We've made a good step to that, so we're moving in the right direction.
If we probably had any foresight and forethought on it.
Right.
We could've got, conservancy or the state to take it over, like on some of the falls down here, we, you know, down
Right.
like that, if the state actually took it over, because that's a historical spot.
Well, you can land a lot of people and tell you so, it don't matter.
So.
Yes.
I mean, but.
That's what we wanna do.
Thought about it.
Is make it to be, I understand the county executive, got the picture of the falls behind it, that's, we want it to be like County Falls, with, that's a better place to go to. Safe, with insurance, place to park, bathrooms, not just a place where people will go and trespass across somebody else's property. And pay property taxes, pay sales taxes, pay.
Well, they knew that road was there, they bought the property.
Sorry?
They knew it was a county road, they bought the property.
Well.
Yeah.
It's been a series, of discussions, I'm sort of the last person standing up, I'm looking at 160 feet. There've been a lot of discussions about it.
Who's gonna pay for the turnaround that you're talking about?
Well, I think that my clients are willing to talk, are gonna help pay for it.
Don't they?
There's really no place to put a turnaround unless they put it onto Ellen Leslie's property there.
Ms. Little, if you talk, is there any more questions for Joel?
Do you have to pay to get into Cummins Falls?
You have to see if it's reserved now, and you have to do that reservation process, so they don't kill somebody down there. You're not gonna have to pay to come out to the baby's place most of the year. Is that planned?
You got a question?
I think we either want to turn it into an entrance middle, this part will really go. Make it such a nice place to come.
You charge people to park, right?
There are now, some of the year.
They still signing away with people, just for leagues, they have to still sign for leagues.
Yeah, but they don't have insurance to cover anything that, you know, happens then. Anybody else?
Are you letting people go down to the falls?
All right, well, yeah, you, are, you got a little.
I'm sorry. The falls are on, actually on Ellen Leslie's property.
Right.
Yeah.
At their co-position with this, and there's some issues there, those, we've been down the stairs recently, they're a bit scared. So we're trying to make sure everybody's safe to go down. Any other questions? Thank you, Mr. Clark.
Lillian, she wants to run through this.
Yeah, I just wanted to make sure that, Ms. Looper has a copy of my recommendation.
I've got it here, I'll give her my copy.
Okay, all right. And the exhibits were left out of the packet, ladies and gentlemen, from page 76 of your packet. This were the exhibits, and the secretary that was doing this, accidentally left out the recommendation, but she put in all the exhibits, so this recommendation goes through the exhibits. I just wanted to say that, you know, part of the problem that developed over a period of time was the fact that the previous owners
property were absent. They lived in, the last property owners lived in Murfreesboro, and the ones before that lived in Texas. So they weren't here in Elgin County to see what was going on at their property. And of course, we know that the reason this was a county road in the beginning is because years and years ago, there was an old grist mill down this road. That's why it was a county road. And of course, that's been gone for years. Even the building where the grist mill was located is gone. I think there's a rock there that has water in it. But for years, and I'm sure y'all are well aware, yeah, this was troubled with drug addicts. It was troubled with prostitution down there. And it's been a very troublesome spot. And the Davies bought it, came in here and bought it, and is trying to start a business there, or bed and breakfast. So, and they're taxpayers here in Elgin County. They bought that property for a lot of money. And, you know, the law is very clear, Mr. Nesbitt and I agree totally. I'm sorry that the public can't use this property anymore, but that's the way it is. You wouldn't want somebody to come on your property that you didn't want on it if you owned the property. And that's the way it is here. You have to be an interested party. This lady I know is a neighbor down there that's opposed to this, but you have to own property that adjoins the road in order to keep this happening. Everybody, the Leslies and the Davies, want this, and I recommend to this court that you approve this. Thank you for your time.
All right, Ms. Littlefield, give you a couple minutes to speak.
My family has lived there for 75 years. My parents, Virgil and Isla Murphy, probably you all know them. And after they left, passed away, I took over the property, and my son lived on one side of me, and I built a new house. So I am opposed to, because the Davies came and started adding gates and closing sections of the road. And now I'm not even sure where they're going to end up with this gate. But they came up to my house and threatened that they were going to close the entire road so that we couldn't get even to our house. So, depending on where this gate goes, I'm believing that my property does touch the road. And I'm going to find that out for sure here in a few days. But I believe that I own on the west side of the driveway that comes around to my house. I own that, which means that it does touch the mill road that they're talking about. But I'm not sure where they're wanting to put the gate. I've never been told that. And they have stopped the road grader from coming in there, and they said that we have to get a signed permission slip from them for the road graders to come in there and work on the road and keep it maintained. And that just doesn't seem right to me at all. So I'm very much against this.
All right. You know what we got to do? You've heard the recommendation of our county lawyer. Recommend that we close that and put that back to private.
Where's the gate
going to
go? Does anybody know where the gate's
going to
go?
John, you'd like to answer that question?
Yes. Best way I can try to is over the hill. You get to come off the new bridge, come down the road, turn left into Ms. McKinley's property, or go straight, and somewhere just over the crest of that hill is where this line will be. So it only touches the Davies and Elgin Leslie's property. That's all we're asking to be closed. It's 160 feet from where the last agreement was. It's up the hill from there. It's basically the part of the road that washes out of the country. And that's mainly so we can protect it. More effect, Ms. McKinley.
So which side of her driveway is this gate going to be on? Is it going to be on the Davies side, or is it going to be where she's going to have to open shut it to come down?
This won't affect her property. The gate
what about the driveway?
Won't affect her driveway at all. This, like I said, don't know, that's when the last time we've been down there.
I ain't never been down there.
Never down there. And come off the main road, and there's kind of a big area, and off to the left, that, her driveway comes off to the left. This is over the crest of this little hill coming down, and it, like I said, washes, and the main reason the babies want to do it is to repair it, so the county doesn't have to keep paying for the gravel to go down the river and end up down the river. They want to put a culvert in and help the water flow through. One thing that's going to begin it on.
So let me be clear on this. It's going to be public access with a trespass fee.
You can look at it.
I mean, that's their team.
I mean, they're running business. That's their property.
If I want to go down there and take a canoe to the falls, I go in there and pay those folks $5 to park the vehicle and take the boat there.
There.
Or I'm not sure they charge.
I'm going to take a canoe. They can interview. Don't go over the fall.
But I mean, I'm just saying.
Yes, that's how they do
what you do.
Exactly. That's exactly it. Park on their property, walk down to the river, and then when you got through, come back.
It's still going to be public access.
Get your cold drink, go to the bathroom right there, they'll get nice.
They're going to have facilities for restrooms.
Yeah,
they're there,
Matt. Okay. All right, folks, you heard what you need to
read correctly. And I just wanted to say that
the
Regional Planning Commission has recommended this to the commission, as well as the road supervisor. Mr. Nord's lawyer was at the planning commission and recommended this to be passed by this commission.
All right, folks. Now, I know some of you have to think about it, but this is our county attorney. She's recommended that we do this, so we need to follow the direction of our county attorney. It's actually, I don't totally agree with it, but it's the best thing we can do for the county. So we're going to go to yes, will be to. Return the 160 feet back to taking off the county road list and off the county map. Shane, you got a question?
Can we have it put in the motion that after this 160 feet, that's it, no more can be taken, that it won't affect her?
Well, I don't think that would be relevant because she owns the rest of the property. That's what we're on. Her property, George, the legend. Am I not right on that? Because I'm correct. But let me add, I'm correct. Her property will, that comes up, the 160 feet will bring it to Miss.
The end of the day.
The end of the day, yeah.
Yeah, to the end of the day.
Elizabeth will have the right part of the property.
If those of you that have been down there, we're supposed to go in off the main road. This is the McKinney's property. There's a private road to the left that goes to her house. And you go home and over a little hill towards the river, and that's Davy's property. That's where the game is playing as you go down the hills. It doesn't involve this lady's property at all.
Ms. McKinney, have you had your property surveyed?
I had it surveyed about 10 years ago, so I'm going to get it resurveyed. But the current survey that I have, that the Davies provided to me, shows that I own beyond the road that's the driveway into my house. So, and they've been up there saying they own the driveway into my house. The Davies came up there threatening, saying that they own the driveway into my house and that they're going to continue to add to the road that they're requesting till there's a gate out at the bridge when you come in that we wouldn't have access to our house. And he said, you may even have to get a driveway through your front yard to be able to access your house.
And that would be a matter that Ms. Silver will have to take up if that happens. But for what we're doing, all we're doing is closing the section of the road that today is on. That's all we're doing.
But are you going to keep giving them more and more and more?
Well,
Walker? Greg Gibbons?
Yes.
Philip Tally?
No.
Geraldine Walker?
No.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
No.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Donna Savage?
No.
Yes.
Six, yes.
Three, pass.
No, five, pass. No, two, pass. Five, no.
Motion carried. All right.
What was the vote breakdown again?
Pardon?
What was the vote breakdown?
It was six, yes, and I had two no's and three passes. What you got?
I have five no's and two passes.
That's 12. No, I can't hear. There's only six votes. You got six yes, and then you had three, that's nine. The other two were none.
Oh, I got five no.
Cindy said pass.
I got Donna no, Jesse no, Geraldine Walker no, Philip Tally no, Shane Walker no.
Is that right?
Which is five.
Patty voted? All right, that's 11. Okay. Anyway, the motion carried by one vote, so it will be carried in the county road list map. At this time. Number 14, consider approval to accept inventory of allowed returns to the county clerk's office approved by the budget committee, highway, and county property. you vote on this at the 30 March 9th meeting at 5 p.m.
Hey, Darwin.
Huh?
We need to back up. I think we might need to do a revote.
That's still the majority.
Yeah, seven, yes, five no.
Yes. It was six yes, five no's.
It's two passes.
That's only one no, but it's just over here. I got 13.
Two passes?
I'm 13.
Yeah.
I voted.
Oh, okay, I didn't.
It was 13, yeah.
Okay. Six yes.
Okay, well, sorry,
Darwin.
We just
kind of
get.
No, that's fine. I just. Back to number 14. Consider approval to accept the inventory of items returned to the county clerk's office. Approved by the budget. Need a motion and a second. A motion by Randall. Second by Cindy. Call the roll, please.
Donna Savage?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Phil Tally?
Yes.
Greg Gibbons?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
Motion carried. All four. Number 15, consider approval for the county clerk to surplus a desk inventory type number 0291. Approved by the county budget to committee highway property. So, need a motion and second. Got a motion by Donna, second by Shay. Call the roll, please.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Greg Gibbons?
Yes.
Philip Tally?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Donna Savage?
Yes.
Motion carried. All four. Number 16, consider approval to surplus the following items from the library dated March 7th. One high back office chair inventory tag number 3547. Four Casio added machines inventory tags 3544, 3937, 4610, and 4861. One, I guess HP monitor, serial number CNC738RT96, inventory tag number 2849. One HP monitor, serial number 3CQ222063M, inventory tag number 3984. Two D-link switches, serial numbers QS511PA A001394. Inventory tag number is 4553, and serial number QS511EB000509. Inventory tag number 4552. It's approved by the Budget Committee and Highway Committee, Highway Property Committee. Need a motion and a second. Got a motion by Robbie, second by Geraldine. Call the roll, please.
Donna Savage?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Philip Tally?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Steve Roberts?
Yes.
All four, motion carried. Consider approval to change the rental rate at the Joel Evans Community Center to match the ag building rate, which is $100 rental fee, $100 deposit, and $50 for the person who oversees the rental. It's been approved by the Highway and County Property Committee, and it was voted on March 9th, last Thursday, 5. Need a motion to change the community center rates to match the rate at the ag building. Got a motion by Jesse. Got a second by Roger Carr. Call the roll.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Philip Tally?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Donna Savage?
Yes.
All four motion carried. Number 18, consider approval of the Sheriff's Department entering into a contract with Global Heating and Cooling for $5,300 annually for maintenance agreement for the heating and cooling system. Once the county attorney approved it, and I'm sure that we have just looked at it, you looked over it.
Yeah, I have.
It's approved. Okay. So you recommend the lease?
Yes.
Okay. Basically, what he's doing, you know, you don't have a, you know, you can talk about it if you want to, but you don't have to have a good heating cooling person over there. You need to have somebody on staff.
Right.
That can call us up with a bad drop.
Right. That's exactly right.
Motion by Randall, second by Jeff Long. You call the roll, please.
Donna Savage?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Bobby Melton?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Philip Tally?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
All four motion carried. Number 19, consider approval to replace the budget chair, Greg Nivens, with County Executive Stephen Barlow, per the 1957 personal law, approved by the Budget Committee. A motion and second. We'll need by vote. What this is about is that we didn't know, the county commission didn't know that they had passed a law where the county executive actually is the chair of the committee altogether from the start. So he is the chair, and he appoints four more people to sit on that board. And also, so you all know, it can be county commission or you can pick someone else. You don't have to be a county commission. If you choose to pick someone from a business or whatever, we can do that. But it's all approved by the county commission, like we do every year. So.
What about where we're supposed to have equal representation
throughout? How's that going to play into that? Well, Lillian, have you found anything where it shows that all districts should be represented? I couldn't find anything under the statute that says that, you know, the county, districts need equal representation. You know, everything we do here now with the committee, everybody has an equal each first district, second district, and it all serves on the board. But I could not find anything that says that it matters. As long as the county executive is the chair and he appoints the four other members, and we don't ratify it in September, we do all the other committees.
Yeah, the law is very clear. Yeah. It doesn't have to be the county commissioners, it can be anybody.
Right.
In the community.
Yeah. Exactly.
But, now it is all county commissioners.
Right, correct.
Yeah.
That's right.
I know.
Go ahead.
I'm not sure the law has been changed. I'm the old book. When I came on the court in 98,
doesn't, I mean, we just get in line. We're doing what the state law says, and, you know, that's what we need to do, so, I need a motion.
Ms. Lillian, let me ask one more.
Sure.
Since that's already a law, you couldn't pass a private act to add to that, right?
Well, we could pass a private act if you wanted to do that, and have it all kind of commissioned.
Yeah, okay, and then have it fixed where you got represented from each district.
Because this is a state law, so.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you wanted to research it, I.
Yeah.
I mean, I wouldn't imagine bringing it outside of the county commission in the first place.
Right.
But it is on there that there's only five members.
Well.
Yeah.
Yeah, five members.
You're the chair.
Yeah.
I thought I read it to Steph.
That's, I researched that too, that depends on population. There's a population, where they can have more than five.
At least six, right?
Or four. So we're gonna have Lillian to look into that for a private act.
Okay.
Okay. We need a motion second to approve that. Got a motion, but I'm second. Second by Randall Baldwin. All four, by signify, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, I say no. Motion carries. All right, number 20, consider approval for the AIA contract between the Overton County Schools and Dublin Design for the CTE addition to the Livingston Academy. Now, that's something they're doing for both locations. We're going to provide for both locations, right? That's what I got, that's what it's about. And so they're going to design a room either back with El Tennis Fourth Floor or somewhere in there behind the school. So they'll build it and get going, and hopefully it's gonna help a lot of kids, because, you know, right now, we're needing a lot of vocational type people not going to work, but we don't have them. You know, we have so many college graduates, we don't have anybody to just make a block or build a house. There's a shortage there, so the school is trying to get on that, get involved in that, and get strength. So that's what that's about. We need to turn to, been approved by the county attorney, I guess.
Dollar, you got a plan?
Yeah, I'll go.
If I understood that right, they're gonna reach out to the seventh and eighth grade in the.
Exactly, thank you.
In the lower grades to.
So they're gonna start early.
To come in to this instead of waiting to get into high school.
That's right. And see, they're already got a career path, working for the vocational department, so, there's a lot of kids that are seniors that are taking vocational department. Do we need, so.
But that Gerald Benz got a question.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Gerald, I didn't see you, Chair.
When they have this, will it be part of their high school curriculum?
I think, from what we heard, if I'm wrong, is that that'll all be a part of the curriculum.
But they don't have to go to college.
No, it'll be, they'll go vocational. That'll be, I mean, I don't know if grants are transferred over, but this is gonna be vocational training, from what I gather.
So when they get out of high school, will it already be a welder?
Correct. See, they fixed to start a lineman school over there. I think they've got that going. I had a guy come by yesterday, talked to me and James about, they're gonna start doing CDL classes over there. So you can go to school there for 7 weeks, and it's 3 weeks worth of class time and 4 weeks driving. So that's gonna start up sometime here in the near future, they were talking about. And then they've still got the building trades, they've got the diesel mechanics, and I can't think of anything else than what they're doing now. This is just gonna help.
Give them nursing, cosmetology.
Here we go. And they're gonna reach out, like you said, to the seventh, eighth grade, get them in line with, when they get to high school, they can keep going with vocational training. So that's kind of what I was saying to be about. So we need a motion and a second. Got a motion from Gerald Ed, got a second from Cindy Robbins. Clerk, we call her up.
Cindy Robbins?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Phil Tally?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Roger Carr?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Randall Boswell?
Yeah.
Lee Richards?
Yeah.
Darwin Clark?
Yeah.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Don Savage?
Yes.
All four. Motion carries. Number 21, consider approval for donors to our renewal for Tamara White and Christopher Trocin Clear. Did I pronounce that? I'm sorry, I said correct. Need a motion and a second. Motion by Don, second by Jeff Long. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, likewise, motion carries. Shannon Candle couldn't be here tonight. portion of it, for sure. Do we have any other announcements? Report, do we have anything else that we need to talk about? If not, next meeting will be Monday, April 10th. And I'll